Thank you for your introduction. Today I'm going to talk about minimum wage. The minimum wage increase is a hot topic these days because labor unions always want to increase, but business firms always want to decrease. Of course, we like to get paid more. Everyone wants to get paid more. But if minimum wage increases too much, then what will happen on the national economy? This is a topic I'm going to discuss for today. First, I will show you some historical data for minimum wage in Korea. And then I will discuss labor market. This is economic theory. I want to give you some taste of economic analysis. And then third topic is how much will be the most appropriate minimum wage in Korea? The minimum wage should be increased further or should be decreased? So we are going to discuss some options here. This historical data shows the minimum wage in Korea from 1988 to 2021, next year. The minimum wage started in Korea in 1988. This is the year of Olympic Games in Korea. And at that time, the minimum wage, the first minimum wage in Korea was less than 500 won per hour. And then after that, it was gradually increasing. And then about 5 years later, 1993, it reached 1,000 won per hour. Around that time, I had a chance to talk to Korean students, and they worked off campus. It was a part-time job. And then they said they get paid 500 won per hour. But I told them the minimum wage at the time was 1,000 won. But they didn't pay much attention on the minimum wage. Because as long as they got a job and they are happy, they get paid about half of the minimum wage, but they didn't know it was illegal. So minimum wage, 1,000 won, is implemented by the law. In that case, the business firms, restaurants or convenience stores, should pay at least 1,000 won, the minimum wage, or above. But those students didn't know about this law at the time. So I suggest them to appeal to the court, but they didn't listen to me. And anyway, after that, the minimum wage was increasing gradually every year. And then in 2001, this was increased faster than other years. So in this case, this is during Kim Dae-jung administration, and then in 2002, it was increasing again. This is the time period of World Cup Games in Korea, joint with Japan. And then after that, the minimum wage was increasing again and again. And very recently, in 2018, it was increased significantly. There's a sudden jump in 2018. This was criticized by many people and many economists. And then these days, the increase is slower than before. And then this year, the minimum wage is 8,590. And then next year's minimum wage is slightly increased. It will be 8,720. And so from this historical data, and we find the minimum wage has been increased significantly. And we are going to discuss, you know, what happened here and why the minimum wage will give some negative impact on the national economy. Let me discuss labor market. The demand for labor is negatively sloped, and the number of workers are on the horizontal axis and wage rate on the vertical axis. So in this case, if the wage rate increases, then business firms' demand for labor, this will be reduce number of workers. There's inverse relationship between wage rate and number of workers. Suppose you are owner of a small restaurant, and you have, you know, five waiters and waitresses. Suppose, you know, you are owner of the restaurant, and then the wage rate increases, then most likely you will reduce number of waiters or waitresses. So wage rate increases, their labor cost increases, and production cost increases, therefore they lose money. So in that case, they reduce number of workers. Or some simple works can be replaced by machine. So anyway, the wage rate increases, the number of workers will be reduced. So firms' demand for labor is negatively related. It's a downward sloping. And then another one is supply curve. Supply, we workers provide our labor. So we work for the company, we work for the university. Okay. In this case, supply curve is positively sloped because wage rate increases, we are willing to work more. So wage rate decreases, we reduce working hours. Suppose you work for the convenience store. You have a part-time job, and you work 4 hours per day. And then wage rate suddenly increased. In that case, you are willing to work more because you will get more money, more income, so you are willing to work more. So there's a positive relationship. Wage rate increases, you are willing to work more. So supply of labor will be positively sloped. So we combine these two, demand and supply, then we can find the market wage rate. So at intersection point, we have downward sloping demand curve and upward sloping supply curve. And then at this intersection point, the market wage rate is determined. Suppose market wage rate is 5,000 won in Korea. Then government considers this market wage rate is too low. So in that case, government can intervene the labor market. In the market economy, everything is determined by demand and supply. But if market fails, then government intervention is possible. Government can intervene in labor market, an exchange rate market, or money market, interest rate market. So money, as long as the market fails, then government intervenes. So in this case, government intervenes in the labor market because government considers this market wage rate, 5,000 won, is too low. So minimum wage is implemented by the law. It is 8,591 per hour. So in this case, we analyze what will happen on the demand side and also supply side. Demand side first. If the wage rate increases from 5,000 to the minimum wage, 85.90, the minimum wage increases suddenly, and then in this case, business firms will reduce number of workers. Business firms' demand for labor is negatively sloped. So wage rate increases, then they reduce number of workers. Some simple works will be replaced by machine. So number of workers, so we lose many jobs. This loss of jobs, this is the most serious problem of this minimum wage. Our society lose this many jobs because, you know, wage rate increases, the labor cost increases. So production cost increases. The firm's objective is to maximize their profit. The profit is the difference between total revenue and total cost. But total cost, revenue is not changed, but total cost increases, then they lose money. In that case, they may reduce number of workers. So this loss of, so many jobs will be disappeared. So this is the result of minimum wage law, minimum wage increase. So this is demand side. We also find some negative side of the supply curve. You know, we workers, if the minimum wage increases, we want to work more because we get paid more, so we want to work more. So our willingness to work increases. Suppose, you know, you after high school graduate, you just stay home and you play computer games at home and you stay with your parents and you don't want to work. So in that case, the market wage rate, for instance, you know, 5,000 won is not high enough. So in that case, you stay home. You don't want to work. But your friends or your classmates has a job, and then your classmates get the minimum wage, $85.90. This is good money, $85.90 per hour. This is good money because, you know, the monthly, you work 8 hours per day, you work 5 days per week, and then the monthly income will be 1.7 million won. 1.7 million. 170,000. That is good money. With that money, you can live by yourself. You can be independent from your parents. You can move out and you can rent a small one-room apartment, and then you can do whatever you want up there without, you know, parents. So your classmate has a job, and then your classmate has this much money, then you also want to get a job. So you apply for the job. As long as you apply for the job, you are officially classified as unemployed. You applied for the job, but you know, it's difficult to find a job because the many jobs disappeared already. So in that case, you are officially classified as unemployed. But before you apply for the job, you are not officially unemployed because you just stay home. You didn't apply for the job. You are not looking for a job. So in that case, you are actually unemployed. You don't have a job. But officially, you are not classified unemployed. But as long as you apply for the job, because the minimum wage increases, then you are officially classified unemployed. So these many people are willing to work, and then those are classified as unemployed. So total amount of unemployment is a lot. It is unemployment, the loss of jobs, so many jobs disappeared, and then plus some people apply for the job, but they couldn't find a job. So these are unemployed because of minimum wage law. This is the most serious problem. So unemployment rate increases because of minimum wage law. Let me summarize this labor market. I'm going to talk about pros and cons of minimum wage law. And you know, no policy is perfect. So any economic policy or any policy, any education policy has pros and cons, positive side and negative side. So nothing is perfect. So first of all, the pros of minimum wage law is something like this. The minimum wage law wants to provide stable income for low-income workers. So low-income workers, you know, especially part-time workers, they work for the convenience store, and then they get paid more because of minimum wage increase. So they have enough money. As I said, 1.7 million won per month. That is good money, good enough for living by yourself. So low-income workers have stable income because of minimum wage. And then income inequality would be reduced. Suppose income, rich people's income and poor people's income. And then, you know, rich people's income is not influenced by minimum wage. But low-income people, they get paid more, so their income increases. Therefore, the income gap will be smaller. So income inequality would be reduced. This is good for our society. But as we discussed, the loss of jobs are significant. The many jobs will disappear because of minimum wage law. Therefore, unemployment rate rises. Unemployment from the demand side and also from the supply side, and total unemployment rate will be increased. And unskilled young workers suffer most. Unskilled young workers are first target to be fired, so they suffer most. Unskilled means less educated. So for instance, high school graduate, they don't have much skills. So unskilled young workers, young means, you know, the inexperienced workers. So high school graduate, they are typically unskilled young workers, and they will be the first target to be fired, laid off, if minimum wage is implemented by the law. So unskilled young workers suffer most. The main purpose of the minimum wage law is to provide stable income for low-income workers, but high school graduates suffer most. And they lose job. High school graduate, I'm talking high school graduate, they lose job, and then they don't have skills, much skills, so and then it's difficult to get a job, new job. So unskilled young workers, high school graduates, they lose job, they don't have any the income. In that case, they may commit crime. So crime rate would be increased. This is bad for our society. And then finally, that the firm's labor cost rises. The wage rate increases, so labor cost increases, so production cost increases. Therefore, the firms will lose money. So they lose money, so they don't want to increase their new investment. So new investment will be decreased. Therefore, national income, GDP, gross domestic product, will be decreased. So based on these pros and cons, positive and negative sides of minimum wage law, you can make a judgment, you know, which one is better. So for instance, the benefit for low-income people, that benefit is greater than greater than the economic cost, especially, you know, for the firms, business firms, the cost benefit is greater than cost, then it's better to exercise, to implement this minimum wage law. But the cost is greater than benefit, then it is not good economic policy. So you can make judgment based on this one. But who knows, you'll be policymaker in the future. You'll be important person for the Korean economy. Then in that case, your decision making should be based on at least some economic theory. Okay. For instance, the minimum wage law has very straightforward economic theory. So based on this one, you can make judgment. And the final topic is that, you know, how much should be increased? How much minimum wage should be increased or decreased? So this is a big issue. But theoretically speaking, I can give you some suggestion, such as like this one. The firm's demand for labor is inelastic to wage increases, then the loss of jobs would be smaller. The demand for labor, the firm's demand for labor inelastic. Inelastic means insensitive. It's not sensitive to price changes. In other words, minimum wage increases 5%, then number of workers are reduced by less than 5%. Suppose minimum wage increases by 5%, but number of workers are reduced by 1%. That means business firms doesn't want to decrease number of workers as much as before. So even if the number, the wage rate, minimum wage increases up to 10,000 won per hour, but business firms, they don't lose much money, therefore they will keep many workers, so the loss of job will be very small. In the horizontal axis, the loss of jobs will be very small. So in this case, it is possible that government can increase minimum wage up to 10,000 won. This is just a theory. But in reality, the demand for labor, the firm's demand for labor is normally elastic. It's very sensitive to wage increases. In other words, business firms have many, many choices. Many workers like to get a job. Many people apply for the job, and they have choice. The business firms have choice. It's very competitive to get a job. And also that, you know, simple works can be replaced by machine. Therefore, business firms have lots of choice. In other words, they are elastic. The wage rate increases by 5%, then number of workers will be reduced more than 5%. Sometimes business firms, Samsung or Hyundai, will move their factory to Vietnam or Myanmar or China. The labor cost over there is a lot lower than ours. So in that case, we lose many, many jobs. That is bad for our society, bad for our economy. So as long as demand for labor is inelastic, it's not sensitive to wage increase, then the loss of jobs will be smaller. But in fact, the firm's demand for labor is elastic in reality. So in that case, minimum wage increases just a little bit, then number of workers will lose many jobs. The loss of jobs will be greater than before. This is just a theory. And another resolution might be based on some intuition, our intuition. Alternatively, international comparison often gives us hints what to do. So I like to compare minimum wages in the United States, in Japan, and in Korea. Especially in the United States, the minimum wage is $7.25. This is federal minimum wage. Of course, the minimum wage in the United States is different in different states. So when you go to California or New York, the minimum wage will be greater than $10 per hour. But if you go to Iowa or Nevada, and you know those small cities, then minimum wage will be $7.25. They use the federal minimum wage. So this federal minimum wage is slightly greater than Big Mac meal, $6. Yeah, Big Mac itself is $4. But Big Mac meal, that includes medium-sized soft drink and medium French fries, so one set meal is about $6. Of course, you know, this price changes in different cities. You go to New York City, then the Big Mac meal will be about $7 or $8. But if you go to countryside, then it will be about $5. So on average, that is $6 in the United States. Then this federal minimum wage is slightly greater than, 1.2 times greater than Big Mac meal. This means you work for 1 hour, and then you get paid, then that minimum wage, that wage with that income, you can buy a decent meal in fast food restaurant in the United States. In Japan, the minimum wage is about 900 yen. This is also slightly greater than famous Japanese noodle, the udon. Udon is 800 yen. If you go to a small restaurant, udon is about 600 yen. But if you go to a fancy restaurant, it will be more than 1,000. But on average, it is 800 yen. So Japanese minimum wage is slightly greater than one decent lunch in small restaurant. So from this one, we find that minimum wage is slightly greater than one decent meal in a restaurant. What about in Korea? Jajangmyeon, this is a famous, popular among high school and college students, and also this is my favorite food. Jajangmyeon cost about 5,000 won. So if you go to Gangnam area, then jajangmyeon will be 6,000 won. But in local market, it is about 4,000 won. So on average, it is 5,000 won. What about Songdo? In Songdo, it is 5,500 won. It's a slightly more expensive than other cities. Then the minimum wage in Korea, so 85.90, this is a lot higher than one popular lunch in Korea. It is 1.7 times higher than jajangmyeon price. This black noodle is very popular, very common for lunch. So in Korea, we can have, you know, with minimum 1 hour minimum wage, then we can have one lunch. At the same time, we can have dessert. But in the United States, in Japan, so just minimum wage, 1 hour minimum wage is good enough for the one decent lunch. But in Korea, we can have lunch and dessert or, you know, nice coffee. So Korea is a beautiful country. We get paid more, and then we can have dessert after lunch with a 1 hour minimum wage. Now, this is the approximate judgment based on our intuition, so international comparison. I didn't include in this slide, but another one is our minimum wage in Korea, 85.90. We use current exchange rate, then this is actually greater than U.S. federal minimum wage, 7.25. Our Korean minimum wage, 85.91, this is equivalent to $7.8, $7.80. This is even greater than U.S. minimum wage. It's difficult to explain this one because our standard of living, is measured by the per capita income. Per capita income in the United States is about $60,000. But in Korea, our standard, our per capita income is just about just slightly greater than $30,000. So our standard of living is about half of the United States, but our minimum wage is even greater than U.S. minimum wage. How can you explain it? This is my homework assignment to the next semester. If you have further discussion, then please let me know. This is my email address. Thank you very much, and Merry Christmas.